Ladies and gentlemen, what is happening? Welcome back to another Scarlet and Violet Wi-Fi battle. Today, I've got a really good match for you. This one is against a team that is pretty damn scary. They're all just sitting there looking at me menacingly. Definitely some big threats over there, but you already know I have brought the heat in the form of kind of some weird lads. Hey, if you're into this type of thing, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. I'm on my way to 300k, it's my goal this year, and we can hit it, but you gotta hit that button first. Speaking of getting hit, my opponent is gonna lead off with the most buff Mexican wrestling bird of all time, the Jalucha, and I just decided to go with my golden nut, who is also a wall. So, you don't ordinarily see a Jalucha as a lead, and you know, as a fortress, I want to set up my hazards. However, I actually expect something like a taunt here. Even if it doesn't taunt, I just go right for the Volt Switch regardless. It does in fact go for the taunt, and that's actually pretty dang nice, because now I get myself a solid pivot, and while I wasn't able to get up the hazards like I wanted to, I am at least able to get some position here. So, I have a few different answers to switch into here, but my best turns out to be Choice Scarf Gallade. Now, the downfall of going into Gallade here, it kind of reveals that I am Choice Scarf, and I lose that kind of aspect of surprise for the rest of the match. However, if he ends up staying in, I'm able to just take care of the Jalucha. Now, there's not a whole lot that wants to switch into my dude Gallade here. His arms are fucking blades, and he now has an ability called Sharpness, which is amazing. Go ahead and chop that boy down like a freaking cut tree in front of Lieutenant Surge's gym in Gen 1, and that takes care of the Jalucha. So, effectively neutralized a young luchador, as now they get a free switch. So I am locked into the Psycho Cut there. And we know that Gastrodon can take at least one of them. It can't really switch into it, especially with the high crit chance on the Gallade, but I do have an answer for this thing, and that is some Ollie. So it actually ends up going for the spikes, which I always forget that this damn thing can learn anyway. Honestly, whenever there's a Gastrodon around, I know I'm kind of in for some type of pain. This thing is extremely defensive and just an absolute McAsshole to kill most of the time. So here, I click the Earth Power. That's because I'm trying to predict the Gengar to come in expecting the Energy Ball. However, he's actually just going to go into young G-Spot himself, the Cloyster. Now, Choice Specs Arbeliva is able to knock this thing down to its Sash, which is really nice. However, Cloyster is a very scary Pokemon for my team. This thing can't really start setting up Shell Smashes at this point, but what it can do is hit pretty dang hard with an Icicle Crash or something like that. So what I decided to do is, looking at my team, there's one Pokemon that doesn't provide much value, kind of looking at the matchup, so I decided to go into Payload. Now the reason for this is just to sack this thing off so I can then get a better matchup. However, if it did go for the Shell Smash, I actually have Mirror Herb, so I'd be able to copy that stat change and try to make something happen. Regardless, it would probably have Ice Shard, and it's just a bad time to be this Payload dropping ass dork. So, not a single load has been dropped this day, but that does open the door for a nice little revenge switch, and sometimes you gotta take one for the team. Payload knows that feeling all too well. So, I decided to go into Low Kicks here. That is because I do have the priority in the first impression, and I'll be damned if I'm letting this damn Cloyster do any more damage here. So, I do go for the first impression here. He actually wants to conserve that thing, and now it's basically sitting at 1 HP, and if I'm able to get up Stealth Rock, that's gonna render that thing useless. So, he decides to go into Gengar here. Now, Life Orb Blow Kicks is still going to do over half on a resisted hit. It does get the Cursed Body, but of course, that's about as useless as a male combi, as, you know, I can't click that again anyway. But I'm not Choice Band, I'm Life Orb, so I can go for the Sucker Punch here and try to knock this thing out as it tries to hit me. But it turns out this Gengar has different ideas, and that it ends up going for the Destiny Bond here. So that's, my Sucker Punch is going to fail. Destiny Bond is not going to do anything because, of course, I'm not being able to take it down. And now it's just kind of like an awkward first date here. So I decide to just dip on the bill and get the hell out of here, as he actually does the same. So, you know, we had the same idea. It ends up working out. So he actually ends up switching into Reptar. That is going to be Cyborg-ass Tyranitar, and a very scary one at that. This thing is always a threat, potential to set up. You never know if this thing is going to be loaded dice, what this dude's deal is. But I decide to go into Walnut, and this actually puts me in a pretty decent spot. Now I have a couple different options I can work with here. I could try to set up some Stealth Rock so that then when the Cloyster switches in, that thing is no longer an issue. Or I can just address the Reptar in the room, which is this thing potentially trying to set up some Dragon Dance. Now I decide the value I get from setting up the Stealth Rock is worth it, because I'm not super afraid of this Tyranitar. I know that it's going to Dragon Dance once. Leftover is going to put me into range where I'll be put into Sturdy. And I can guarantee that I can take at least one attack from this thing and then whittle it down with a Gyro Ball. And then hopefully Low Kicks can first impression and knock that thing out later. So that is the plan. I did not think about the fact that it's probably going to be an attack that's multi-hitting, so my Focus Sash is not going to work. And that's about when that sets in. So I'm thinking, okay, well, I have to stay in here and I really need to get some chip damage off on this Tyranitar. I cannot Terra, because I'm actually Terra Fire, and that's not going to help me against, like, a Rock Blast. So, he actually stays in, goes for another Dragon Dance, which is pretty dang good for me, because now I hit this thing with the gyro ball, get some pretty decent damage to the point where now I'm feeling comfortable with that chip. And now I'm thinking, you know what, I could probably still take an attack here regardless. I'm max HP and defense fortress. This thing is an absolute unit, and he actually ends up missing the first rock blast anyway. So I spin myself into a little gyro ball and hit him once again, knocks him down to red, to where now easily first impression takes care of it, and he goes for the rock blast here. But even with the 5 hits, it's looking like I could potentially live this. So it's one way to get around to Focus Sash, but first, you gotta make sure you can kill me first. Walnut is an absolute unit. Defensive is Titties, able to live that with 43, and then one more Gyro Ball. He's able to take care of it. So that first miss was unfortunate, but it doesn't really make that much of a difference in the game, because the second one would have knocked me out, and then I would have still hit it with two Gyro Balls because it Dragon Dance twice. And then first impression from the low kicks is gonna take care of it. And now, you know, Fortress is in a position where pretty much anything can breathe on my dude and knock it out. So he decides to go into Gastrodon here. Snail Mail is still going to be faster than me, but I decide to just click Rapid Spin. He does go for the Earth Power and knock me out. So that's fine. I'm able to at least take care of the Iron Thorns, and that's pretty much all I needed there. That's all I needed Fortress to do. We also were able to set up the Stealth Rock, so cannot ask for more out of my goldest little guy. So now we get to switch into pretty much whatever we want against Gastrodon, and this opens the door for Arbeliva to be able to come in and just absolutely wreak some havoc here. Nobody expects this thing to be running the Choice Spec set, but it actually hits extremely hard. So what I'm going to do here is essentially just go for the Energy Ball, expecting maybe they think I'm going to overpredict. I just decide to go for the Energy Ball because it's going to hit anything pretty dang hard, except for freaking Noivern. This thing comes in with his big-ass speaker ears and absolutely just soaks up an Energy Ball right through the ear hole. So going for the Dazzling Gleam there would have been my best bet. But now I have to assess the fact that Noivern is a huge threat to my team. But I'm gonna end up going into the most purebredest good boy ever. There's never been a gooder boy in the history of Pokemon. We go into the Bread Dog, and he actually ends up going for the Defog there. So while that gets rid of the Stealth Rock on his side, it also is gonna get rid of the spikes on my side. We also notice this thing is carrying heavy duty boots because it didn't get hit by the Stealth Rock switching in. So Noivern out here flexing them boots, and I'm actually in a pretty good spot with the Dots Bun here. I can go for a Play Rough. And I know that this thing cannot knock me out, so something's gonna have to take a Play Rough here. Unfortunately, of course, like I had mentioned before, this fucking snail is the absolute death. I mean, it's more of a slug, but it's it's the freaking bane of my existence, even having a grass type. But I go for the Play Rough. I don't have the most offensive power on this Dotsbun. It's mainly here to just be able to kind of soak up fire attack, switching into stuff targeted to Arbeliva, and then be able to body press and just kind of have some decent longevity with that Wish and Protect. But now I'm in a position where I definitely can easily just switch right back into Arbeliva. Even if this thing does go for the Ice Beam, I can definitely take that. And then the same play switching into the Noivern again isn't going to, it's going to happen quite as easy, because I can expect that coming. So Slug Snail just wants to set back up some Legos on my side. Running around barefoot is going to be not too comfortable. But I mean, that's totally fine, because now I'm in a position where he either has to sack something or he can try to make the play back into the Noivern. So I'm honestly thinking that maybe this time he just ends up staying in on the Gastrodon and just expects me to predict. So I just go right for the Energy Ball here, trying to make the safest play possible. But he does actually end up switching, and he decides to, turns out, sack the Gengar here. So Gengar comes in, and even the resisted Energy Ball hit is going to knock this thing out, because olives are absolute superfood, able to take care of the ghost. So that is amazing. Gengar's a pretty fast and big threat out of the way. But now he gets the free switch, and he does decide to go into the Cloyster. Of course, he did defog those Stealth Rocks that I worked so hard to put there, and now this 1 HP having ass is kind of a problem here. But what I do have is, again, a very defensive loaf. So I decide to go into the Dotsbun here. Purebred is, this thing is basically just trained to be fully defensive, and if there's any time to be fully defensive, it's against this damn Cloyster. So he does go for the Icicle Spear here, not feeling safe enough to go for the Shell Smash, having its Sash already broken. And as we're going to see here, the 5 hit on the Icicle Spear with a critical hit is going to do just around over half to me. So I'm thinking maybe after Leftover Recovery, I should be able to get an attack off on this thing. And I'm thinking, please, Bread Dog, I could really use your help here. So I'm going to end up going for the Protect, because I got some Leftover Recovery, puts me to around half. And I decided to just go for the, just Raw Dog the Protector. Ordinarily, I'm supposed to be Wish Protect, but I figured just with that one, and one more turn of recovery, I have a chance to be able to take another Icicle Spear. So we're gonna really put this thing to its absolute limits here, and also hope that one of the 5 hits is not a freaking critical hit. The thing with its built-in skill link ability, which is essentially, you know, just built-in loaded dice. But it does go for the Icicle Spear here, and I'm thinking, please don't crit on any of these. Knocks me down to 59. I'm feeling pretty comfortable about this. But there's the critical hit, and I'm like, oh no, this is not, this cannot be. It knocks me to 25. One more hit knocks me to 10, and Bread Dog is able to make it happen. Defensive, that's when comes in clutch, and a play rough does take care of the Cloyster. So that is one way to do it, and honestly, in a match against a Cloyster where it doesn't have the ability to set up a Shell Smash, it's kind of just a win regardless. So I ate a little bit of leftovers, just take a bite out of my left bread paw, and that heals me. So now they get the switch back into the Noivern. This is kind of the main thing that I'm worried about at this point. However, I'm feeling like Choice Scarf Gallade is going to be able to clutch the match for me here. So he's actually going to end up going for the Terra. Now, whenever you see Noivern, you can pretty much expect the fact that it's going to be Terra normal. With that stab, Boom Burst now is extremely scary. This thing is a very large threat, and it's also very fast. But you know who is faster is my sharpest lad, Gallade. So he does go for the Boom Burst there. That is certainly some overkill, as Dotsman was not going to have a chance to live that. But I did what I needed to do with that thing, and now I can go right into Gallade and hopefully just kind of clean up the match for myself here. So HMO1, sharp as hell, ready to do some cutting. And this is why we run Choice Scarf Gallade. I'm actually adamant with the scarf because I know, even adamant, I'm able to outspeed max speed Noivern, which is actually pretty great with that Choice Scarf. So I go for the Sacred Sword here. That is actually boosted by the Sharpness ability. If you're unfamiliar, a new ability called Sharpness is going to give us a nice little boost on attacks that are freaking sharp. So pretty much everything Gallade's got is going to be boosted by that. And Gastrodon, turns out, is no longer a switch-in. I do way too much damage to this thing without a critical hit. Sacred Sword is extremely powerful. Now I just got to go for that once more, and then the last Pokemon is going to be that Noivern with the diamond on his head. And I'm hoping at least that my calculations were correct and that I should be able to outspeed. Because if this thing goes first, I definitely just die to a Boom Burst. And that is not ideal. But I decided to just test it out. Don't even need to use my Terra. I know that it's going to kill regardless. We do outspeed, and the Sacred Sword slices that diamond right in half. That is how sharp this dude is. Straight up cutting diamonds. So that is going to be the end of the match, and that was a super good one. This team is extremely fun to use. There's a whole lot of kind of fun options on this squad. And I thank you guys very much for watching. I do appreciate all the support on these videos. Definitely leave a comment. Let me know if there's any Pokemon you'd like to see me specifically try to make work. And I'll see you guys next time. Peace out.